A boy went back to Napoli because he missed the scenery, the native dances and the charming songs. But wait a minute, something's wrong, 'cause now it's
hey mambo, mambo Italiano, hey hey mambo. Mambo Italiano, go, go, go. You mixed up a Siciliano, all you Calabrese do the mambo like a crazy with a hey mambo. Don't wanna tarantella, hey, hey mambo. No more mozzarella, hey mambo. Mambo Italiano, try an angelada with the fish baccalà and then hey gumba. I love how you dance the rumba. But take some advice, paisano, learn how to mambo. If you're gonna be a square, you...
Pagliai's Pizzeria was established by the Pagliai brothers in 1967 and is today one of the oldest pizzerias in the town of Bowling Green. It's the only Pagliai's in Ohio and is still the only pizzeria in Bowling Green to serve its pies buffet style. During the 80s, Pagliai's was caught in a war when BG set the record for the most pizzerias in a single town. Pagliai's dominated against 25 other pizzerias with their spaghetti specials, award-winning soups, and a secret ingredient that no other pizzeria could copy. What's Pagliai's secret ingredient? It's George Nicholson.
And anyway, I was in Macomb, Illinois when they set up a pizza house there, and I'll go up there and wash dishes. Hired on, and they said, I'll make you a pizza maker. So I made pizzas there in high school, and after I got out of high school, I was only making 85 cents an hour, and they said, you go to Iowa City, you make $100 a week. So I said, I'm going to Iowa City, which was a lot of money in 1965, and worked in Iowa City for a year, and Sam said, hey, you want to run a pizza house? And I said, sure. And he was setting them up at the time, of course, in Bowling Green, Ohio was one that he got. So we came over here in 1966, and finished the building. It was a little tin shack, which would remodel the suit, and put in leather booths and all the kitchen, and open in February of 1967. Been here ever since.
But they don't thrive on pizza alone. Pagliai's garnishes their buffet with the freshest fruits and salads that claim town recognition. Each morning, George arrives early to cut the lettuce and prep the kitchen.
When I was about 20, I never knew how to cut lettuce, and I'd usually take a knife and cut it like this. Anyway, this is pretty cool. You just pop that with your base of your hand. And I don't know whether people see that, but if you're not in the restaurant business, you wouldn't see that. And I think that's cool. Lots of times when you're really mad, you can take out some aggression on the lettuce. And I think that's sort of fun. The best lettuce in Wood County, because we do it fresh every day. And this machine makes it so easy to do. A lot of pizza houses, and I'm not picking on anybody, let's say the chain stores, okay? You eat a chain store pizza because it's just cheap. And then when you really want something good, you'll go to maybe Miles, or maybe you'll go to Pagliai's, or maybe you'll go to Pizzanello's. You'll pay a little more, but you'll get fresh ingredients all the way through, fresh dough, and a lot of stuff that we make right here in the store, as compared to having it shipped in on a truck, and you don't know when it was made. But especially the doughs of the chain organizations. I think we have a good crust in our thin. Traditional thin is mine, although we have a screen crust and a pan pizza now because customers wanted. And so we allowed them to have that style of crust. But making fresh and making it every day is very important. Plus expanding our menu. We started out with pizza and pop. That was it. Then we added a sub. That was 90 cents too. And then we added spaghetti. And the neat thing about spaghetti is we had a spaghetti special, and I don't know what the cost was normally. It was probably $2. But every Wednesday, we sold from 5 to 9 for 99 cents. And we would just pack the place for the 99 cent spaghetti special. And that went from 1968, when we started spaghetti, until probably 1980, when we moved across the street to our new location here. And then, of course, the price of beef got to be so expensive we kept moving it up. And now we have a spaghetti special, but the spaghetti special that you got for 99 cents now costs $6. Just sort of the way the dollar went and the economy went.
We're in pretty, I probably should do this. Celery, parsley, and two onions. We make spaghetti sauce, and I learned from Sam Pagliai in 1969 how to make our sauce. So every week, I'm doing the spaghetti greens, what we call them, for the spaghetti sauce. And if we have time later, I'll show you how we run these through.
Every Tuesday,
we make spaghetti sauce, and we make spaghetti sauce on Friday, too. And can I have one dough pan, Norm?
Yes, sir.
And this is the old recipe that Sam Pagliai gave me. Ever seen onions this big? Gee, many Christmas. To do the parsley, I need to have a different setup here. Again, fresh vegetables. We don't have a vegetarian sauce per se. We just have Prego in a bag, and we just use that for the people that don't like meat. And I'm sort of prejudiced here because I like the meat sauce spaghetti that we have. I'm coming in here for the special secret recipe. Oops. With each grain, these are jalapeno peppers. With each grain, spaghetti grain, I throw in about 6 jalapeno peppers, and that gives it just that little bit of zip. Jalapeno peppers. Parsley. Onions, those great big onions. I'll finish it off with the celery. Anyway, this would be one spaghetti sauce, and I've dumped the green in it already. This is the second spaghetti sauce, and I'm dumping the green in it now. And then, of course, I'm going to rinse this container out with hot water because that'll get all the jalapeno juices and so forth. So Sam Pagliai would be very proud to see this old guy still making his spaghetti greens. Yes, just like he taught me how. 46, 47 years ago.
However, George accounts the freshest ingredients as only a part of Pagliai's success. He has learned throughout the years that it takes more than good food to make the best pizzeria.
Well, because we've been here so long, we have a definite advantage there, and because we really commit to have a relationship with our customer, not just you're another dollar, you're another tip, like the commercial, or you see that some of those songs. Another ice cone dip, another dollar. We like those dollars, don't get me wrong, but we try to do more than just get that dollar, okay? We want to connect with that person so they can feel like they want to come back. And I think that's more important. As I don't as work as much, I think our crew does a pretty nice job, but they still like to see me because they've seen me for 45 years. And if nothing else, it's just a hi or how's your meal, you know?
Most of Pagliai's long-term success has been associated with their business outside of the campus. If you walk into Pagliai's today, you might just meet one of their very first customers.
Our kids were raised here. We've come here for clam chowder for most Sundays for 30, 35 years.
But yes, lots of times we'll have fourth generation people here because you'll have, you know, the kids and their grandkids and then their kids. It's amazing. And I like to say we lose more business through funerals than we do any other way because these people pass on. But it's neat that they brought their children and their children, which carry on our customer base, and we're there for them.
I know. Troy, how long you worked here?
Almost 10 years.
Oh my gosh! That's scary. We have too many guys that have worked almost 10 years. And I always forget.
I think George is one of the most passionate and long-standing people I've ever worked for. You know, I've never met anyone that's dedicated themselves to one single thing for as long as he has. I mean, he's here every morning doing what he does. You know, he never stops. I hope at that age I can be doing the same, you know, have the same kind of dedication to something.
Pardon me?
What do you think of George Nicholson?
Oh, he's a great guy. Let me tell you what. He's a great guy.
Pagliai's Pizza. You could say a destination. You could say we'd like to make your family our family. Things like this, because I'm corny. And lots of times corny is okay, you know. I never did probably evolve out of the 60s and 70s. And I've always tried to keep that type of work ethic, those type of morals, and I've just carried them right on through. Whether it's out in the community working, whether it be at church, which has also probably helped business, but not because I go to church do I want more business. I go to church because I choose to. But out in the community with scouts, parades, different benefits going on, I'm there to help. I'm there when I can to help someone in need. And that probably comes back to help us. And that would probably be a simple way of saying it.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling.